Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today we're going to talk about how to export or save layers from Photoshop into separate files. And the reason you might want to do that is if you're a web designer and you've created some web pages in Photoshop, you already have sized those images the size that they need to be. Now you just need to get them as separate PNG files for your web developer. So Photoshop makes this really easy, and I'm going to show you how starting now. Okay, so here we are in Photoshop. This is a website I made for big time warehouses. It's just a fake website that I made up. And now I want to get all of these pictures out of it and save them all in separate files. So first I'm going to save a copy of this. And I really recommend you do this because you don't want to lose your good information. So I'm going to save this as just copy maybe. Okay. And now I'm going to use my command key to highlight everything that I don't want in here. So I'm going to command drag from this side and just delete all of those. Whoa. I don't want to delete my background because it's kind of hard to tell what's going on without it. So I'll command click to unselect that. And I see that I have a picture here that I don't want to delete. That is this one. So I'll deselect that one. And now if I hit delete, it's gotten rid of a lot of things, but not my pictures, which is what I want. Now I'm going to lock the background layer, and I'll just command and draw a box around these. And I'm going to hide them with command comma. I'm also going to do the same with this picture, command comma. And then we'll grab my header image. I'm holding command and dragging over part of it. We'll command comma to hide. Now, I think I probably want to save these icons, so I'm going to command comma and hide all of those. And then there's one right here. I'll command click on that one and command comma to hide it. Now, everything else here I don't want. This is all stuff that can be made with icons and CSS. So I'm going to command and draw a box around all of that and then just hit V and delete. So now I'm left with only the things I want, I think. I see a couple of icons. Oh, there's some things in here. I'm going to zoom in with the Z tool. And I'll do the same thing. I'm going to command and then draw a box around these images because they have this overlay and this little icon thing that I don't want to save separately. Anyway, I have all those selected now, so I'm going to command comma to hide them. And I will command draw a box just around these and then command comma to hide those. And now I'll command and draw a box around these, hit V, and then hit delete. Whoops, I accidentally got this picture. So let's go and deselect that and now hit delete. Now I'm going to hit option, command, and comma to bring everything viewable again. Now we have just the images that we want to export. Now it's a good idea to kind of go through your layers and make sure that everything is going to be exported correctly. So if you have some adjustment layers on these, you'll want to rasterize those first. I don't think I have anything like that though. I'm going to ungroup all these, kind of get rid of my groups so I can see what's going on. I'm just doing Shift Command G on those. So I can easily see what layers are going to get exported as files. And now I'm going to go ahead and rename all of these. If you rename them, it'll save them as that name, and that's really helpful. So I'll call this Hero Image, and I'll go ahead and rename these all right now. I'll speed it up for you. Okay, I've got everything renamed now, so I'm going to unlock my background layer and then throw it away. You probably don't necessarily need to do that, but it just makes it a little easier to see exactly what layers I'm going to get. Now we'll go to File, Export, Layers to Files. Now here's where you can set up a lot of different stuff. I'm going to set the destination to a specific folder. We'll call this one Big Time. The file name prefix, I don't really want a whole lot of stuff in front of the file name, so I'm just going to delete that. But this would be good if you had something you wanted at the beginning of every single file name. The file type, we're going to change this to PNG 24. Now, if you change this to JPEG, you will not have the option to crop them. So it's going to make every image the size of your entire canvas, and I don't want that. PNG 24 works very similar to a JPEG. I would just do it that way. So we'll include a transparency and include trim layers. Now let's run this. Okay, and then we get a dialog box that says it was successful. We'll say okay. We'll go back out to our folder and take a look at each image and save them all. It cropped them correctly. It really is pretty awesome. So Photoshop just has this built in, and it's a really easy way to export and save your layers as separate files to pass off to the development team. Please let me know if you have any questions, and if you like this video, please click the like button, and I will see you all next week for another graphic design tutorial video. Thank you.